Question is from Nathaniel L. Watson. How much information should you know as a new personal trainer? I listen to you guys, but I can't hold a candle to you.
Yeah, you know, I tell you what.
Fuck, bro. We've got two decades on you,
and
man,
think about
give yourself a break.
And also think about who you're going to be working with. Now, if you're going to be working with clients that are very advanced, let's say you're going to be doing like really, really hard advanced correctional exercise work with people who have big time injuries or rehab, or you're working with athletes at very, very high levels, you probably need to know a lot. But if you're working with the average person, the average everyday person who just needs to get in better shape, you actually don't need to know that much. You really don't. You need to know some stuff, but you don't need to know much. Here's what you do need to know. Know how to communicate what you know very well.
There you go.
And stay in your lane. That's about it. Stay in your lane. And if you don't know something, be okay with letting them know.
Listen, when I started, I had no background at all in this. I mean, I had to plan to go to school for kines, but I was still in my first 2 years, which you don't even get to teach any of your major courses anyways. So I had no real background. I failed my NSM the first time that I took it. I was a terrible trainer for probably the first 5 years. But the one thing that I was really good at, which was what Sal just pointed out, is the ability to communicate the information. And I was very comfortable with saying, I don't know, but I will find out for you. And within 24 hours, I would have that answer for whatever they asked me, no matter how simple you think the question is or how deep and technical it is. And part of the motivation of us creating this platform is to support trainers just like you. I mean, that if you don't have the free app at Mind Pump Media and you don't have that downloaded, that should be first, because you have a search engine in there where you could put in any topic that we've ever addressed in the last 1,300 episodes. So then you could listen to us break it down and simplify it there. We've got all the free guides at mindpumpfree.com. We've got a YouTube channel, Mind Pump TV, with now, I think, 500 plus videos. We have a plethora of free information and blogs all over the website.
Plethora.
Use the resources to go back and present to them. And I think why some trainers don't do that, and I always laugh when I meet somebody who knows Mind Pump, and I ask them if they use these tools, and they're like, "Oh no, I haven't really done that." It's like this. It's the scarcity mindset. Like, people are afraid, like, oh, if I refer them to a Mind Pump guide or YouTube, maybe they won't buy training from me. Like, that's so stupid. Like, don't think that way. Like, you as a trainer, they will appreciate you getting the right information or good information communicated well to them more than anything else.
Yeah, send your client to our episodes, and I promise you, they'll get more sessions.
Yeah, right.
Well, you'll completely appreciate it.
No, it's true. And then I meet some trainers that are really good about that. They totally use our resources, and their clients, the two of them, they have discussions all the time. Oh, I heard this on Mind Pump the other day. What do you think? And the client and the trainer are always talking about it. Like, use all this free content that we have provided.
It's funny. I used to have this conversation. This is a very common conversation I would have with new trainers that would work for me, because when they would first get started, inevitably they would feel a little insecure, a little nervous. I don't, you know, it's my first time training people. I got my certifications. You know, I've worked out for a little while, but, you know, I've got these new clients, and I feel like I don't know enough or whatever. And I'd say, look, 99.9% of all the information you know, you're not going to use it anyway with clients. This is a everyday person. They just need help moving more. You need to strengthen them with basic exercises. Do you understand basic exercises? Good. Do you understand how to apply those exercises? Good. You're perfect. Can you communicate that it takes a long time, that it's a slow process? Does your client enjoy seeing you? This is another big one. Mm-hmm. Does the client enjoy meeting with you and working with you? Don't worry about the fact that you don't have the most technically knowledgeable trainers that I ever had working for me. Very little clients that ever have to absolutely send to them. You know, like, I'd get the one client that would come to me and be like, "Well, I've got problems with C6 and C4, and my doctor said this," and then I would send them to my rehab trainer. But most clients are like, "I want to lose 20 pounds. I haven't worked out for 10 years, you know, and my knee kind of hurts, and you know, I'm not really doing anything right now for activity." It's like, okay, cool. Any of my trainers can do a phenomenal job working with you. You're going to be in your working out 3 days a week. Any of them can do an awesome job. And that's pretty much it. Just be confident and know that what you know is more than enough to help the average person, and you'll be absolutely fine.